In this video, we will cover how to use an Amazon S3 bucket to store snapshots offloaded from a Pure Storage flash array using CloudSnap. Please refer to the CloudSnap documentation for how to create and configure a bucket and connect it as a replication target to the flash array. We are logged into the flash array GUI, and from the left-hand side, we have selected the Storage tab. Under Offload Targets, you will see that we are currently connected to an S3 target called Pure Bucket. Setting up replication from the flash array to the S3 bucket is really simple. All we have to do is create and configure a protection group. So we go ahead and click on Protection Groups to create one, and then we click on the plus sign to create a new protection group in this case, and let's call this Database PG for Database Protection Group, and create it. And it gets added to the list of protection groups that are on the array. And we'll go ahead and click on the protection group and configure it. The first step is to add the data that we want to replicate. In this case, we will pick, let's say, Volume Database 2 to replicate and click Add. And then we go ahead and add the replication target. And we will choose the Pure Bucket as a replication target. And the third and final step is to create a replication schedule. So first we enable the schedule. We leave the replication frequency at once every 4 hours. And we keep that for 7 days, and then we keep one snapshot per day for, let's say, an additional 30 days, and click on Save. Now, as soon as we've done these three steps, this triggers the replication to start. So if we now go back to the Array tab to look at our target, and go ahead and click on our target, and then go ahead and click on Sort by Create, we will see that replication of the protection group that we just created has started, and the data is starting to offload from the flash array to the S3 bucket. Replication is now complete, and around 32 gigabytes have been transferred to the S3 bucket. Let's take a look at what the S3 bucket looks like at this point in time. Remember, this data is stored in the S3 bucket in Pure proprietary format, so it cannot be accessed directly by users. It has to be restored to a flash array in order to be accessed. The flash array creates directories and subdirectories in the S3 bucket and stores multiple data and metadata files in them. Please do not modify any of these files, as they will result in data loss. Let's go back to the flash array GUI, and this time create a manual snapshot. So we go to the protection group that we want to take a snapshot of, and under protection group snapshots, we click the plus sign. We give it the optional suffix name, let's say manual snapshot in this case, and we click on apply retention and replicate now and hit create. And this should create the snapshot. Now let's go back to our target and take a look at that snapshot. Let's sort by create it. And you will notice that the latest snapshot on the top transferred 0 bytes. That's because after the initial baseline copy of any data, for each subsequent snapshot, we only send the delta changes. The process of doing restores is even simpler. You simply browse through or do a search for the snapshot that you want to restore, and you hit its download button. It asks you which volumes in that protection group snapshot to do a restore for. We only have one, so we select that, and then we give it the optional suffix name of restored database. And we hit get. And it comes back and tells us that the restore was successfully accomplished. So let's go to volumes, and under volumes, let's take a look at snapshots. We see that restored database is now a local snapshot on the flash array. We can click on the menu and hit copy to create a volume from the snapshot. Let's give the volume a name. Let's call it restored database and hit create. This should create a local volume on the flash array. Let's go ahead and refresh the volumes menu, and we see that restored database is now a volume. Let's click on the volume and connect this to a host so that we can connect to the volume from the host and access our data. This concludes our overview of how to use CloudSnap on Pure Storage Flash Arrays. Thank you for watching.